Pastor Camp's reaction to this development in the Senate? Will the pastor submit himself to authorities who will serve the arrest warrant?
Well, first of all, we respect the decision of the Senate. And but of course, Pastor Quiboloy will exert all available legal remedies to protect his constitutional rights. Now, as to the pending arrest, that's the personal decision already of Pastor Quiboloy. No? We have given him enough legal advice on how to deal with the issue. So at the end of the day, it's going to be his decision.
And when you say you have given him legal advice and that his camp will exert all efforts or to address these legal issues, what advice did you actually give the pastor?
Well, we explained to him the legal position why he should not attend the Senate hearings. No, first of all, it brazenly violated his constitutional Bill of Rights. No, as you are all very much aware, the Senate hearing is tantamount to usurpation of judicial authority. No, and any and all proceedings being made thereon is virtually trampling upon the Bill of Rights of the pastor. No. So he cannot cross-examine the witnesses. He cannot scrutinize the statements. So the affidavits, as every lawyer knows, is a mere scrap of paper if it does not undergo any form of cross-examination. So these are, among other legal ramifications, we explain to the pastor his rights, no, under the Senate hearing investigation. Now, with the warrant of arrest already issued, again, it's up to him, no, on how he would want to deal with the said order of detention.
All right. Attorney Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri earlier mentioned that they also tried to have back channel talks with the pastor and his camp. Why didn't that prosper? Why? What was missing during that discussion? Why weren't senators actually able to convince the pastor to attend the Senate investigations?
Well, first of all, I'm not aware of any form of back channeling. No? Apart from the fact that there were suggestions that he appear, and through, I think, Senator Robin Padilla and Senator J.B. Ejercito. Apart from that, I have no personal knowledge as to any specific kind of back channeling which was done by the Honorable Senate President Zubiri.
All right. I understand that your camp is quite bent on not allowing or discouraging, at least, the pastor from attending the Senate inquiries. While your camp can easily snub these congressional investigations, what you cannot simply brush off are show cause orders from a court, arrest warrants issued by courts. I understand that there are at least three pending. Let's talk about that one by one. First, a non-bailable human trafficking case against Pastor Quiboloy filed in a Pasig City court. Your thoughts on that, attorney?
Oh, first of all, Katrina, I'm not the lawyer handling those cases. No? As I've said many times before, my representation is limited to the Senate hearings and probably if and when there is already an extradition treaty. No? So again, going back to your initial statement, let me be clear about the fact that the pastor has never disrespected or snubbed the Senate hearings. No? We were just saying that the pastor cannot be duped into appearing in a trial by publicity, no? So all these things combined with the clear statements or categorical statements of no less than the chairman of the committee that the pastor is already guilty, no, of the crimes being leveled against him is well enough, no? Would be enough reason for us to discourage the pastor from appearing therein, no? Because, you know, the Senate is not the dispenser of justice in this country. Only the courts, no, can declare the guilt or innocence of Pastor Quiboloy. In fact, we were even saying that even if there are friends of the senator of Pastor Quiboloy who would eventually clear him again, that would not hold water, no, because the only legitimate agency of the government which cannot clear or convict the pastor would be the judiciary, you know.
Right. And speaking of the judiciary, as mentioned earlier, there are also several cases filed against him in several courts, aside from the one in the Pasig City. Just for the information of our viewers, he also has child abuse cases in Davao City, with a bail for sexual assault against children amounting to 180,000 pesos and a bail for maltreatment against children for 80,000 pesos. As you mentioned, you are not in charge of these cases, but are you at least privy as to how the pastor is taking in the stack of legal cases against him?
Oh, as we previously mentioned, Katrina, that is the proper procedure, right? Because by then, the executive already is executing the laws. Remember that these charges are already covered by existing laws and special laws, no? And therefore, it is the most appropriate procedure, no? That should have been done, no? The Department of Justice, as the executive branch of our government, should lodge the cases before the judiciary, no? So the judiciary, in turn, will hear the evidence on both sides, no? And after weighing all these pieces of evidence, that's the only time that the judiciary could come out with a legitimate judgment, no? In contrast with what is going on in the Senate. If you will notice, what's going on in the Senate is that, you know, they are parading witnesses with masks, now with aliases, and there's no way for us to really identify their legitimate names. And we cannot even ask them questions, no? And again, the pastor is already being convicted even before the Senate hearing started. So these are all our serious apprehensions, which are brazenly violating the presumption of innocence, the constitutional right of the pastor to be presumed innocent until proven guilty. So it's going to be a useless exercise, Katrina.
All right, attorney, walk us through what can potentially happen once the Senate Sergeant at Arms serves the arrest warrant for Pastor Apollo Quiboloy expected today. What will happen? How will his supporters, how will his camp actually deal with this? Is there any guarantee that the chaos will not ensue in the camp from the camp of Apollo Quiboloy?
Again, Katrina, I cannot speculate, no, on what's going to happen. As I said at the very outset, it's going to be a personal decision on the part of Pastor Quiboloy, no? So, of course, as a lawyer and as a citizen, I would not want any form of anarchy or disorder or even bloodshed to occur by reason of the arrest order on the part of the pastor.
All right. Attorney, can you guarantee that Pastor Quiboloy is still in the Philippines?
Oh, I am most certain that he's still in the Philippines. As I said, he is more than willing to appear, provided it is in the proper forum, that is before the courts, not in the Senate, where trial by publicity, as many people have mentioned, no? Political scientists, legal expert, no? Would declare that it's a trial by publicity. No? If and when proper cases are lodged in court, then that's the proper time for the pastor to appear and face his charges and face his accusers face to face.
All right. He is willing to appear before a local court. What about a court from overseas? We all know that in November 2021, the FBI has issued an arrest warrant against Pastor Quiboloy, and they have recently unsealed that, perhaps as a precursor to an impending request for extradition.
Again, based on our extradition treaty, there are certain processes, Katrina. No? As long as these processes are observed, we guarantee you that the pastor will recognize that. No? Not through the Senate hearings. No? So as long as the treaty, which was signed by the Philippines and the U.S. government, is followed, then we will face all these charges arising from those.
For extradition, we'll first have to go through the Department of Foreign Affairs. And once the Department of Foreign Affairs accepts that, it will then be forwarded to the Department of Justice before the Philippine government can actually make a decision on whether or not to turn over the pastor to federal authorities of the United States. How are you preparing your client for this legal battle?
Well, of course, we will prepare as they come, Katrina. And again, at this juncture, we cannot disclose our legal strategy at that. But the basic point is, as long as there is due process being observed, the rules on evidence are strictly applied, okay? The accusers come face-to-face with the pastor, then we will face all forms of charges.
And what measures is your camp taking to appeal to the government to at least not turn over the pastor to U.S. authorities and instead hear his cases here here in the Philippines first?
Well, of course, it is our thinking that the Philippine government should have first crack, no? So to speak, on trying the good pastor here in the Philippines, no? But then again, at the end of the day, it's going to be the decision of the Philippine government and the trial court or the judiciary if they will allow the pastor to be tried in a foreign land through the extradition treaty.
Frankly speaking,